Okay, so now we can rebuild Doxygen. So let's get back into our sources directory and BLFS. Extract Doxygen. Got a few switches to turn on here, so let's just create the build directory we're working in and then the configuration. And hopefully now this last switch should work. Let's build it. Okay, so that's done. So let's run the tests. Let's make tests. Okay, still seems to be failing, unfortunately. This still seems to be the same make ones. That's a bit strange. Anything I can think of is that maybe the TextLive installation needs some more of the packages that we've got left to install, so I'm going to leave Doxygen rebuild for now, but we'll come back to it. So I'm just going to abandon this. And I'm going to go to do one of these other ones. It's outstanding. I think I've put off a few times. Do Oh, yes, it's this GDB, that's right. Yeah, this asymptote and so on. I'll come back to do them. But I'm going to do this GCC build and then the guile, and we can get this GDB done then to get it reinstalled. And that's just like to extend tests by the looks of it. So let's get these two up. Let's just save it there. So it says if you're upgrading GCC from any other version prior to another two, which we're not, you must be careful about compiling third party modules. Should ensure that the kernel and all its native modules are also compiled in the same version of GCC that you use to build a third-party module. Does not affect the native kernel, so I don't think that's a problem with us at the moment. So it says some system headers need to be fixed to be used with GCC. This is done during the installation of GCC and the fixed headers are installed in user lib GCC machine triplet GCC version include fixed. This is harmless if GCC is built during the LFS stage, which we've done. But if you reinstall GCC in BLFS, some of the BLFS packages may be fixed. If one of these packages is reinstalled afterwards, the fixed headers are not updated, which may lead to version mismatches. In case that happens, the fixed headers must be updated by running root as that. So, I wonder if it says that. It doesn't actually say that, so we need to probably remember that after we've done this. So we've got GDB already installed, Deja Nu, Valgrind, ISL for graphite. I'm not going to install that. So I think we've got TCL, we've got expect and Deja Nu. I wonder why it doesn't. Yeah, we have. I wonder why it didn't specify those three as optional. Okay, so let's start with this. Yeah, it's downloaded. Okay, so let's put the configure in. So we're building it for all these extra languages which we need for GDB for testing, and I think there may be one or two other packages that require it. Let's see, we've got disable multilib. Don't want that, we want to stick with the 64-bit. System.zlib, enable languages. So there's no other configuration. Okay, and let's start the build and see how long this takes. Okay, so that's finished building. Let's now test it. So similar to how we did this in limits from scratch, just set the limits to maximum and run the test. As it says, the test is going to take longer. There's more languages being built, and also got the Falcon and GDB, so it's going to be bigger coverage. It says it's 390,000 tests, so it's going to take quite a while. Okay, so that's tested, it's finished. So let's do this contrib test summary command to view the results, and we'll pipe it through less. So on the in the book, it does say that there's about 100 which fail in the quality suite, which are these first ones we can see here, and a few passes or unexpected passes. Looks like we've got that lot. There's a summary there, unexpected failures 95, so yes, that's approximately 100. Got some unexpected successes, didn't say how many of them to expect. But over a total of 120 unexpected. Let's see what the other sections have got. Unexpected failures in G Fortran. I didn't specifically say what there are, but as long as we haven't gotten over the 120, we should be okay. There's a couple failed in G++. I vaguely remember in the LFS that were two PR failures. In fact, they're all the same test. They're failing in different ways. Again, though, it's in the quality part of it. So I think we can skip over that. There's one there for Go. Okay, there's locale ones. Oh, I think it's easy. No. I can't remember if that was ones we saw previously in Linux from scratch. There's eight unexpected there. So, yeah, that looks like there's no more than 120 failures. So, to me, that looks like a good result. So let's become the root and install the new GCC. So this bit, next bit, is saying that some packages prefer the name CC for the compiler, but it says the following symbolic links are not needed if you've followed the LFS instructions since they've already been created. So we can just double check for these. User lib. Right. It was in lib. CPP. That's it, yeah. So that one's obviously there. That one's there, so you can see that they have already been done. So that should be it. The only thing we need to reread is this note. Where was it? Oh yes, this bit here. Some system headers need to be fixed to be used with GCC. This is done during the installation of GCC, and the fixed headers are installed in, etc. This is harmless if GCC is built during the LFS stage, But if you reinstall GCC in BLFS, some packages may be fixed. If one of those packages is reinstalled afterwards, the fixed headers are not updated, which may lead to version mismatches. In case that happens, the fixed headers must be updated by running as root. So let's run this command as root. And that seems to have finished. So that's GCC done. Let's tidy up. And now let's get Guile and install this one. Okay, we've already got it. Oh, this was for... It needs GDB, but we've already installed it, haven't we? Let's just get my spreadsheet back up. Just check what we've got in here. All right, yeah, it's not Guile I need to do. I thought I needed to redo that. It was just GCC, yeah. So I need to really deal with Doxygen. I wonder why that's not working, because the rebuild I got is to rebuild GDB after Doxygen and GCC have been built, but Doxygen, I still can't get it installing with the documentation for CLang for some reason. I'm not sure what's happening there. Use the switch of LLV with CLang uninstalled. Total support for... Oh, no, it's not documentation for lib CLang passing. If you require formulas to create PDF documentation, you must have text live. So, it doesn't seem to be anything to do with... what I thought would be the text line for this switch here. That's a bit strange why that's not working. So I might... GDB, let's just have this GDB. Right, I haven't got... actually got anything to do with LLVM directly, so I might just reinstall this now, and that'll be another one off the rebuild list. Yeah, let's do this one now. So let's create the build first, build directory, and then copy the configure. Let's check what commands we called. System readline is there. Python is nothing else. Okay, so we can just put that in and build it.